Sup, bitches?
I'm here to present, for your viewing pleasure, my picks for UFC 80,
Sloppy Jalopy.
Going on the premise that they're just making shit up, I might as well too. First, we will start at the bottom of the card. James Lee will submit Legionarius Alessio Sakara in the first round, probably within the first second, because Sakara is so bad. I'm sure he was a fine boxer. He should go back to that. Moving on to our much later. Paul Kelly versus Paul Taylor, Battle of the Pauls. Loser can't be called Paul anymore and must go by the name of Shirley. Either way, I don't care. Colin Big C Robinson will fight Anthony Hardonk, and unless Robinson is being brought in for an impressive win over Hardonk, I'm picking Hardonk to win, probably KO due to his kickboxing type abilities. Moving on, we have Sam Hands of Stone Stout. I just realized I was leaned way over. How you doing? Sam Stout will be fighting Per Eklund. I believe it is pronounced Per. Sam Stout should fucking Ponzoor. Probably TKO or KO, unless he's been working his submission game and wants to show that off. I don't know much about Per Eklund. I think his name's been bandied about a bit, but not a lot. So moving on from that, we have Kendall Daspider Grove versus Jorge El Conquistador Rivera. Thinking Kendall Grove would like to win this one, probably by TKO, unless of course he would like to submit him. Probably second round in there somewhere. He doesn't usually waste a lot of time. And George, he calls himself George, but everybody pronounces it Jorge, which, I don't know, take the hint, dude. Yeah. And then we have Marcus Davis, the Irish hand grenade, don't ever change it to the Celtic warrior again, God, versus Jess, the Joker Liondon. Marcus Davis has impressed the shit out of me since he's been on The Ultimate Fighter. Everybody is either in the same boat as me or is like, Marcus Davis overrated. I don't like him at all. He's a punk. But I like him, and he will probably win by TKO in the second round because what, I gotta explain myself to you now? God, get off my back. Moving on to the third and last event of the evening, we have Fabricio, no nickname, Verdum, versus Gabriel Napão Gonzaga. Gonzaga has lost to Verdum in the past. Verdum has trained with Krokop in the past. I'm not sure if he still does. Napão was last seen getting ponzoored by one Randall Couture. Wanted for such crimes as ponage, double ponage, and ultra kill. I believe Gonzaga shall be motivated to return like a house of fire. Whereas Verdum kind of didn't look very good against Arlovsky, but then neither of them looked good in that fight at all. But he did get the bitch slap in, that was hot. I'm going to say probably Gonzaga, probably by decision, because I think while they're both extremely good at jiu-jitsu, and they've been both working on the hands, I don't see one of them holding an advantage, unless one of them's working crazy overtime, which I don't know about, because I don't fucking train with them. Moving on to our second to last event of the evening, we have Jason the Punisher Lambert against Wilson. I'm too mean for a goddamn nickname, Govea. I like Jason Lambert to win this one because I think they're both going to come at each other like crazy people, and I think Lambert's got more power. Then again, Wilson Govea has leg kicks to kill people with, so he'd probably make me look like an idiot and beat Jason Lambert. However, I still think that Lambert could win this one. And will. And should. And a main event of the evening, we have Joe Daddy Stevenson versus BJ Lazy Fat Hawaiian Pen. You might be able to see where I'm going with this already. People are smart. Scotchy, scotchy, scotch. I believe Joe Stephenson will get the decision. If not, then I will eat something vaguely distasteful. No, I won't. I won't even do that. I don't care. I hope that BJ never holds another championship for as long as he lives, because he is the single most overrated fighter in the history of the fightering year. In my opinion, this is a BJJ prodigy that has went for 4 years, almost, what is it, 3.5 to 4 years without a submission win. And he wasn't inactive, he was fighting. And then he got his submission win versus Jens Pulver. I mean, come on. Impress me. A little, please, if you wouldn't mind. Yeah. Joe Stephenson is going to train harder. Joe Stephenson has fucking crush power. Joe Stephenson, they both used to fight at 170, so don't tell me that one's going to come in stronger than the other. BJ is more flexible, but Joe Daddy is stronger, and it doesn't matter because Sean Sherk will fuck them both in the ass and then have them pay him for the pleasure. Can you dig it? Word. Yes, I have been a bit distracted of late because my kitty has been very sick, and it has made me very sad and preoccupied a great deal. So, I'm sorry for not putting up any more videos. I do have questions for the next busy video, which I will be doing at some point. I don't know when. Yeah, that's pretty much it. If you guys have any more questions or anybody wants anything answered or my opinion on something, God knows I'll give it to you. That's about it. Peace off.